let's do that one. Okay. Okay, welcome to the Fuck the Stigma episode 2 of
Reaction.
We're reacting to Euphoria once again, and I'm here with Lydia today.
Hi, I'm Lydia.
Wait, like, did you do drugs?
Recreationally. Yeah.
But you had like a substance abuse issue.
Yeah, I was weed. I mean, alcohol was the problem.
Alcohol was your issue?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So I brought Lydia here, a different perspective of, does Euphoria accurately portray addiction? Do we relate? Did we have these experiences? I'm kind of like rating it a little bit. Have you ever watched the show?
Yeah.
You watched the show?
I've seen it all. Yeah.
Have you personally like related to some of the behaviors?
The behaviors, yeah. I just started rewatching season one and it's crazy because now that I've been through recovery or like going through the meetings and shit, it's like, oh, the serenity prayer.
Yeah, dude, I caught that too. Yeah.
Did not notice that when I watched it the first time.
Yeah. My apple juice.
Apple juice.
I love apple juice.
Apple juice is great.
We're gonna do, the first scene we're gonna do is Maddie finds out about Nate and Cassie. In this part of the show, she starts, like her addiction's getting really bad and she starts like wreaking like chaos in different parts in her.
Havoc. Yes. She's just going around sprinkling shit to like keep the focus off herself.
Yeah.
Hey Cass.
Yeah?
I have a quick question for you. How long have you been fucking Nate Jacobs?
What are you talking about?
Oh, I saw her get in his truck and then kiss him and drive off. That was like what, like a month ago.
Cass, that's like really bad.
You're fucking Nate? Are you kidding me?
No, I don't even know why she would say that.
You're lying. Can we just table this conversation?
So like seeing fucking like Rue just like, this is like this where she was like running away trying to like hide, right?
Yeah, I think she's like kind of kicking it right now.
Yeah, like you saw like how sweaty she was,
like uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Is her mom there too?
Yeah, her mom.
Okay, her mom.
Yeah, either she's there. I think she's there in this scene, and it's just like, dude.
Runs to their house and then starts all this shit, like trying to get away from her mom.
Yeah,
she goes there.
Good shit.
No, you expect me to stand here next to my best friend who's been lying to me about fucking my ex-boyfriend? I'm okay. Literally gonna get violent.
We are having an intervention. Stop it.
I'm begging you. Let's just get into the car. I can't.
The most self-centered, idiotic person I have ever fucking met. You fuck my ex and you're fucking crying? I don't even know why you're believing her. She's a drug addict.
Shit.
I probably would have said the same thing.
I know. The thing is she's like using anything she can. She knows what's gonna hit deep enough to take the focus off of her completely.
Yes.
Like,
and this is supposed to be your intervention, which is an amazing way to get out of an intervention almost. Have you ever had an intervention?
No. Have you?
No. I didn't have that intervention experience, and I'm very grateful for not having that.
I had little stabs, little comments here and there, like...
Yeah. All right, well, she killed that. Let's see.
I'm gonna be honest. Let's just do it later. Cat, shut the fuck up! How long have you been fucking him? When was this?
Right after New Year's.
You dumb fucking bitch! I'm gonna you fucking run away from me, you stupid bitch!
Guys, come on!
So slick. That was her escape.
That was hardcore.
Beautiful. Yeah, how did you perceive that scene?
First time I watched it, I couldn't really like pick out or notice, but like now, like I was just saying, seeing just how manipulative that was. It was like, oh, I know what's gonna really distract him. Like nothing else was working. And she's like, you know, I'm gonna fuck up their lives real quick.
Yeah.
Take the focus off myself.
Yeah. Good shit. Okay. The breakup scene.
Oh, fuck, fine.
Relationships and addiction, dude. I personally really liked Rue and Jules together.
I know, we really did.
Okay, are you ready?
I guess so.
Scene number two.
I haven't watched this sober, so.
Sober?
I haven't watched it sober.
Oh, okay. I see what the fuck is going on here. Well, first things first. Elliot here's a fucking addict. So if he tells you anything fucking different, he's a liar and a fucking snake. Fuck you.
Isn't it kind of, isn't it?
Oh, man.
When I was, like, in my, like, when I was in my addiction, like, I didn't even know what, like, addict really meant.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, I couldn't blame somebody for being an addict for being, like, a liar and a snake. But, like, I knew the behaviors of somebody who did drugs often.
Yeah.
So, like, I knew I couldn't trust them on a certain level, but it's also funny that she's saying that when she does the same thing.
I know. I think it's interesting because Elliot is obviously, like, an addict, but he's not at Rue's level, you know?
Almost slightly manageable.
Yeah, like kind of a functioning addict, if yeah. there is that. But, again, she's just deflecting.
Yes, like, deflecting like crazy.
Cares about you. This doesn't
fucking concern you, Jules.
Yes, it does.
Fuck, it does.
Yes, it does.
How?
Because I don't want you to kill yourself.
You're a fucking rat!
You were lying to me.
Yeah, so you gonna tell my fucking mom?
I didn't know
what I was. Wait, I have that shirt.
Oh my god.
I literally have that shirt. That's what he gave it to me. With saying things don't concern you, like of people who care about you, first of all, like, weren't they dating?
Yeah.
And like, it doesn't concern you?
Yeah, like, it doesn't concern you. Well, when you're in that kind of headspace, the only thing she can see is, like, her little lie and her, like, trying to protect or save herself, kind of. It doesn't matter. Like, nobody else matters, but she's trying to get her next fix, so she's not focused on, like, anybody in the path.
Yeah.
You know how people say that? I forget how they phrase it.
And also the, like, what is that called? Frothy emotional appeal?
Yeah.
Of, like, I don't want to see you kill yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And then you not caring, almost. Yeah. You not caring about, like, doesn't concern you if I die.
No.
Yeah.
Scary. Why the fuck would you say anything?
Why would you say anything?
Yeah.
You are fucking dead to me.
You don't mean that.
I fucking mean every fucking word. You're dead to me, Jules.
I don't believe you.
You and me, we're fucking done. You know, I have a lot of regrets in my life. But I gotta tell you, Jules, meeting you has got to be at the top of my fucking list.
I've said that before.
I don't wanna fucking cry. Yeah, you're a fucking vampire. You just go around fucking sucking the fucking spirit out of everyone. You like that shit. Makes you feel good.
You know that's not true.
It is fucking true. It's all about fucking Jules, right?
I love you.
No, you don't. Stop saying that! You don't love me! When I fucking needed you, you fucking left me when I was at my fucking lowest. You fucking left me at my fucking lowest, and a real fucking friend, someone who fucking loves you, wouldn't do some shit like that, Jules. If you want to help me, you can just stay out of my fucking life. Forever. That would be great, because honestly, looking at you makes me physically fucking ill.
Oh my god.
Do you think she means this stuff?
I don't think she really means all of it, but it's interesting because, like, didn't Jules leave her though, like, for Elliot?
I don't recall. I don't think she knew about that. I don't think she knew about Jules and Elliot. I don't remember. I think she did.
I can't remember if it was it, but she definitely found out at some point. And it's true. I think Jules, like, kind of, I don't know. I would be pissed if that were me and I had found that out. And it's like, no, I love you. Fuck you.
Yeah.
I would probably, it's hard. I don't know. That's tricky.
I think there's parts of it that she meant. And, like, the huge, like, gasp of air, like, almost like, a little panicky, like hyperventilating-y. Mm-hmm. I think she feels a lot. She does feel hurt. I feel like they feel hurt by each other.
Yeah.
And then like her kind of caking a little bit isn't helping.
No, no.
And it's just like making it. Like, I'm sure she said things she, like, later
would
regrets.
Not have said. Yeah. Of course.
But that's what we do. Mm-hmm. That is very much what we do.
Sorry, baby. Okay.
I shouldn't have said anything.
Do you think he should have said anything?
Yeah, do you think... I don't know. I'm trying to remember, like, if he did that out of, like, the goodness of his own heart, or kind of, like...
I think it was like a worried friend, but he does the same thing, just not to the same extent.
I don't know. I see both sides of it, because it's like...
What are the both sides?
Both sides being on that side of like, it's not your business. But then there's also like, oh, well, he was trying to help, but was he?
But was he? Or was he like doing it out of like, I want jewels?
Yeah, like it could have been. I don't know. What do you think?
Tricky. I think... Being someone who got sober, I think it was kind of necessary. That was... It's like, I think it's really necessary for people to care for like an addict in their life. And like, mm-hmm. kind of like, dude, you need to kind of straighten up a little bit. But if he didn't say anything, something else, like it could have been like later in her mm-hmm. life where like something intervened. But I think like it was bound to happen.
Yeah.
Like somebody was bound to kind of say something, do something. Mm-hmm. So I think it was just a matter of time.
Yeah. And she's just mad because she didn't want it to get out. She wanted to keep living that like.
Yeah.
I liked her the way she was. And this shit was never my place.
Hmm. Okay, that last scene.
Is that like the last few
that last
seconds?
Little snippet, ooh.
Yeah, I think he thinks slash knows it kind of wasn't his place.
But I do think after that last sentence, he wanted to help because it seems like he doesn't have that big of a problem. Like the way it shows him is like he could take it or leave it.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not that way for Rue, clearly.
She needs it. It's never like, never your place to share somebody else's business, but.
But there's gotta be, yeah, there's gotta be like, if somebody's life is kind of on the line, it's like, are you willing to take that kind of backlash to help somebody else? Like, they might not see it now, but then like later, say she gets clean, she'll come back and be like, I'm sorry, thank you.
Yeah, she might be thankful for it in the future.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, would you have appreciated that in hindsight?
In hindsight, like looking back at it?
Yeah.
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 Probably.
I would agree. Maybe in hindsight, I would... Oh, wait, look. This is, like, literally the next scene right here. I think she's, like... I think this is the scene where she goes... Like, I think she's gonna go to rehab.
No. And then she just starts running.
Yeah, dude. Okay.
Oh, this is so bad.
Oh. But real! Okay, this is the next scene.
I'm gonna take you to the ER, okay? Okay?
I'm sorry!
No.
Baby, help me detox, okay? I'm sorry! I just missed out!
Me too, baby, me too.
I missed him a lot!
I know. Me too. Can I take you to the hospital? Shotgun.
The no communication.
Sad. When does she decide that that's what she's gonna do? Like,
you wanna know the truth?
I was just gonna run out of the car.
Yeah, like,
dude, she probably realized when she got in the car.
Wait, does she? I can't remember. Is she about to just like go off on her mom and sister now?
Let's see.
I relapsed as soon as I got out of rehab.
Let's just get you back into rehab.
Wait, what the fuck are you talking about, Mom? I thought you said we were going to the ER.
Yeah, baby, it's the same thing.
Oh, no, it's right not here. The fucking same thing.
It's not the same thing.
Okay, those are my fucking chances. 1 in 20.
All I know, if you set your mind to it, your chances are higher.
Dude, probably the crazy effect this has on her sister.
I know. It's like from the first season, first episode, like you see.
Yeah.
I don't even know how old she is, but she just has to find her sister, OD'd. Yeah. And then like watch her older sister. Like she has to be in the shadow of that her whole life.
Yeah.
Like that's her. Oh, that sucks. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what's... They should do a show on Gia.
Show a spin-off on Gia?
Yeah. Just her life.
Yeah, and she's just talking herself out of it right now, going back. It happens quick, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Well, everybody's mom fucking says that, okay? Even the ones who bury their kids.
It's funny, because if you guys didn't do this fucking intervention shit, I was about a month away from killing myself.
Fuck.
I have this image in my head of me just, you know, laying in the sand and letting the waves just kind of take me out to sea.
Mom, I can't do this. I can't do this. You guys need to let me out of this car.
I don't care.
I don't want to fucking do this.
It's okay, baby. We're almost there.
It's not fucking okay, Mom.
Can't do this. I'm sorry, Mom. I can't.
Yep. It's like stressful to watch. It's like, does she even know where she's going? Like, what's the goal here? That's what happens when you unwillingly are being taken to rehab.
Yeah. My God. I feel like there's like she causes accidents too. Like people are like hitting each other and then eventually the cops are chasing her.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
And she's also talking about like being suicidal.
Like in front of her poor mom and sister, like, oh yeah, I have this image of myself like.
Yeah, dead, I mean, on the beach. She was keeping it real for sure.
Yeah.
Do you relate to that?
Do I relate to what?
That's like the feelings in the scene?
Just, I mean, I feel like unless somebody really wants deep down to get help, everybody, the more that people try to push them to do that, it's just gonna like scare them away. Even if they want it a little bit, yeah. The more that they feel like they have to or people are driving them there, it's like, do anything to get out of it, you know?
Yeah, like they have to come to that decision on their own.
Yeah, until somebody does,
it takes a lot to like come to that decision.
Yeah, well it takes a huge, like, bottom.
A huge, you know? Bottom. And then like her bottom, a huge bottom.
Oh, fuck.
And for her, I feel like her bottom has been just like fucking up friendships and relationships so
and
far.
And she doesn't feel it yet though. Like she doesn't feel it. She's just she's so on that, go.
She hasn't had that time to process those feelings.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think Euphoria accurately portrays addiction?
I think there are definitely some like truths to it, but it is also like
TV.
TV, yeah.
Yeah.
The producer, the writer of it, is in recovery.
Really?
Yeah, so it's playing off of it really well. Better than anything I've seen other than Beautiful Boy. Have you seen that?
Beautiful Boy, no. Yeah, that's what I want to do on this show.
Come on.
I'm going to do that on the show.
That's the best. It's a TV show to keep anybody interested, even if they don't know anything about addiction, don't care, really. It's not like in their circle. I think it's cool because if you get any knowledge on addiction and then you watch it, you can see like, oh, this is actually like trying to kind of broaden the awareness around it instead of just some kind of fun TV show.
Yeah.
You know?
Fuck yeah, dude. We'll do Beautiful Boy next.
Beautiful Boy.
But thank you for coming on here, Lydia, and watching this. I appreciate the perspective you have shared.